If you're confused about the difference between glucose and insulin and want to get the correct answer once and for all, then you don't want to miss today's episode. We're breaking down the crucial roles of glucose and insulin in your body. Understanding these two can help you manage your health more effectively. Let's start with glucose. Glucose is a simple sugar that your body uses for energy. It comes from the foods you eat, especially carbohydrates. This includes minimally processed carbohydrates like fruits and vegetables, and more processed carbohydrates like bread, pasta, and sweets. When you digest these foods, they're broken down into their most basic form, which is glucose, which enters your bloodstream from your small intestine. This process raises your blood sugar levels, providing your cells with the energy they need to function. But glucose can't enter your body's cells on its own. It needs help from a hormone called insulin. Insulin is a hormone produced by the pancreas, and its primary role is to regulate blood sugar levels. When you eat, your blood sugar levels rise from the carbohydrates that are digested, and this signals your pancreas to release insulin. Insulin flows into the bloodstream, looking to help get that glucose to where it needs to be in the body. Insulin binds to its cell receptor and acts like a key to unlock the cell, and that allows glucose to enter the cell to be used for energy or stored. Without insulin, glucose will remain in your bloodstream, resulting in high blood sugar. When blood sugar levels are elevated, the body needs additional insulin to help transport glucose into the cells. As a result, the pancreas produces more insulin. Over time, high levels of insulin will lead to insulin resistance, where cells become less responsive to insulin, preventing efficient glucose entry and requiring more and more insulin. Here's an example for you. Think of your cells as parking spaces in a busy parking lot, with insulin acting as the parking attendants directing the cars or the glucose into those spaces. When everything functions smoothly, the attendants efficiently guide the glucose cars into the available spots. However, if too many cars keep arriving and the parking lot becomes crowded, the spaces become harder to access, and the attendants may struggle to direct the cars. This leads to a backup at the entrance, resulting in increased blood sugar levels. As the parking lot gets more congested, you might need to bring in more parking attendants or more insulin to keep the cars moving and help them find a spot. This situation illustrates insulin resistance. Initially, the body responds by producing more insulin to manage the rising traffic, similar to hiring additional attendants. However, this doesn't address the underlying issue, which is you have too much glucose in your bloodstream to let those cars enter effectively. With elevated insulin levels and continued congestion in the bloodstream, blood sugar levels remain high, creating a vicious cycle. Over time, this can lead to complications like prediabetes and type 2 diabetes, as the body increasingly finds it challenging to maintain proper blood sugar control. Glucose and insulin have to work together in a delicate balance. Think of it like a seesaw. Neither can function properly without the other. If one side becomes too heavy, it requires more of the other to restore balance. In a well-functioning system, stable blood sugar levels are maintained, but problems can and will arise when this balance is disrupted. So how do you keep glucose and insulin levels balanced? Here are a few tips. Focus on a low carbohydrate diet with adequate protein intake. We recommend eating 1 gram of protein per pound of ideal body weight every day. Next is to perform daily physical activity for at least 30 minutes, and we highly recommend strength training all major muscle groups at least twice a week. Third is to manage your stress and prioritize a healthy mindset. All of these are key components to lowering your blood sugar and improving your insulin sensitivity. By incorporating these strategies into your daily routine, you're going to be well on your way to taking charge of your health. And if you need help increasing the protein in your diet, be sure to download our free ultimate food guide. There's a link in the description because we have tables of both plant and animal-based food sources that give you the serving size required for the minimum dose of 30 grams of protein per meal. I hope you found this video helpful and have a better understanding of the difference between glucose and insulin. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more insights about insulin resistance and lowering your blood sugar. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.